handbrake. Mostly I'll be describing aloud what I'm doing. I'll do this in a few takes with different camera angles. Hopefully it'll help. So, once again, my gear shifter's in neutral, not in any particular gear. If ever you're curious, you're driving around, you don't know what gear you're in, and you're worried that you're in a gear as so and afraid to stall the car, you could always just tap your gear shifter to the left or to the right, and if it returns to the center neutral position, then you're not in any particular gear. To specify, by me holding it to the left or holding it to the right, I'm still not in any specific gear, which is good. I'm still in neutral. It's only when I move it either up or down that I put the car in gear. So, that being said, let's begin. To begin, you probably can't see this, but I'm pressing my foot down completely on the clutch. Once again, move the starter to the ACC, move it to the on position, wait till all the lights show, give it around 3 seconds, turn it on until the motor turns over, and release. There we go. I'm now in 1000 RPM. Since my gear shift is in neutral, I can release the clutch without any fear of stalling the vehicle. Excellent. Okay. So, first thing I do with my right foot, I apply the foot to the brake pedal, disengage the handbrake. The car is now free rolling. If I were to release my foot, right now I'm not on any particular incline or decline, so I have no worries. If I was on a particular incline or decline, the car would be rolling in any specific area. Okay, first trick I'm going to show you. This is a trick I learned when I started to drive manual, and this could help a lot of people. What I'm going to do is I'm going to, while holding the brake, completely press down the clutch, put the car in first gear, release the brake, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly take my foot off the clutch. I'm going to feel a little bit of hesitation. I'm going to check my blind spot. There we go. I don't know if you can tell, but we're now rolling. I'm rolling ever so slowly. So I've now completely released my foot off of the clutch. My car is just under 1,000 RPMs, but it's still enough to keep the car in motion. So I don't have to worry about it stalling. The car is rolling. I have no feet on any pedals. It's important to note that my gear shifter is in first gear. If it was in any other gear, then chances are I would stall the vehicle. If I apply pressure to the gas, I have now climbed to 1,500 RPMs, 2,000 RPMs, and 20 kilometers an hour. Check my blind spot, I'm going to turn to a quiet street, but my street's pretty quiet. There we go. I'm maintaining 1,500 RPMs, 20 kilometers an hour, and still rolling. Now that I've built up speed, if I were to my foot off of the gas, off of the accelerator, and I would let the RPMs just descend to nothing, I would probably stall the car. So what I need to do in order to come to a stop is I'm going to apply my foot completely, fully pressed down to the clutch, pull over here, I'm going to put my car in neutral. I won't have enough power to clear this person's driveway. Don't want to block the driveway, I'm just going to move it a bit. And there you go. That's an easy way to start up. There's a pro and a con to this. The pro is that you don't need to learn the finesse of moving your foot off of the clutch while moving your gas, moving your other foot onto the gas, because there's a balancing act that needs to be perfected in order to complete this. The bad side is if you're at a light or if there's somebody behind you and you're trying to take off in this method, it's extremely slow. And if you hesitate, you could cause it to stall. How would you hesitate? Let's say, for example, you're waiting for the car to start up in a slow method. You apply a bit of gas and then you take your foot off the gas very quickly. What will happen is your RPM gauge will shoot down, your car will stall. and then you're making the people behind you wait even longer because you have to restart the vehicle, put it in gear, and take off.
The other method
is to do a more uniform and more modern takeoff. Now, you can't see the RPM gauge right now, but right now I have it in neutral. I'm going to apply it a parking brake so it doesn't roll anywhere. And I'm going to put a bit of gas, a bit of pressure on the accelerator. There we go. The engine revs. If you have an automatic car at home, you could try this exercise by making sure to put your car in neutral. There's a neutral gear, an N. Don't forget that. You put it in neutral. You apply a brake, whether it be a handbrake or a parking brake. Make sure there's a brake on, and apply just a slight bit of gas. If you have an RPM gauge, you'll see the RPM gauge increase. If you don't, you'll hear the engine rev up a bit. This is the balancing act that you have to manage when driving manual transmission. Right now what I'm doing is I'm applying my foot, my left foot, completely down on the clutch, putting my right foot on the brake so it doesn't roll anywhere, disengaging the handbrake, putting the car in gear, releasing the brake with my right foot. My left foot is still engaged on the clutch. Now you may be wondering, if I release the brake, if I'm on an incline or a decline, won't my car roll? Absolutely it'll roll. That's why it takes some time to get this method just right, because if you don't, if you take too long, you can roll into something that would be dangerous. So, right now I'm on a flat surface, I don't have to worry. Disengage the brake, move my foot to the accelerator, and here's where the balancing act happens. I will slowly apply pressure with the gas as I slowly release my clutch. There's a moment where they'll both be level, and then as soon as the car has enough momentum to move, I can release the clutch completely. There we go. The car's moving. I'm keeping my eye on my RPM gauge as I disengage my clutch. My foot is now completely off of the clutch. My right foot's on the accelerator. I'm doing 2,000 RPMs, 20 kilometers an hour. I am now going to press down my left foot again. I've completely released the gas. Whenever you press down the clutch, release the gas, because if you don't, this is what happens. Your engine revs, but you don't move anywhere, because your car's not in gear, because your clutch is pressed down. So, car's in gear. I'll change gears, put it in second gear. Once again, same process. Light pressure on the gas. If I ever pause in my speech, it's because I'm driving at this time. Still have to keep an eye out for traffic. Okay, here we go. Once again, first gear, second gear. First gear from a stop. I'm at 1,000 RPMs. 2,000 RPMs just to get enough speed to move. 20 kilometers an hour. Back to 1,000, obviously. 30 kilometers an hour. That's all. Stop. All right, turn signal. Watch what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna put the car in second. You could begin a roll in seconds. It takes more attention to the clutch and the accelerator, but the advantage of it is that there's one less gear to go through. And since there's one less gear to go through, even though second is a slower acceleration than first, you have more of a range to go. For example, I'm just going to pull over here. I'm going to tell you at which point I get 3,000 RPMs first. 1,000, 2,000, 2,005, 3,000 RPMs. The best I can do is 23 kilometers an hour. So no matter what, if I start in first gear, I have to shift relatively quickly. Right now I got a curve here. Something comes to a stop. Car parked here. Sorry, I have to use the gear shift. Stretch of road. Don't block anybody. Okay. Let's see how much I could do in second gear. Second gear. 1,500 RPMs. 2,030. work out there. In an automatic car, it's a different situation, though. In an automatic car, you start with the car in gear. It's very difficult to switch in and out of gear. I'm now taking the highway. To neutral, gauge parking brake, since it's neutral I can release everything, no danger.
Okay, so, still have a flashing light, I assume you're working.
Okay.
I say a lot of okay, sorry about that. Where can I put you that you will see what's going on and still be legal? Should have thought this through, shouldn't I? Okay, let's learn how this thing works. This thing does not pivot more than this. Where can I put you? Okay. distracting. Can I put it like this? Oh, I can. Oh, that's good. Is it? Yeah, you're showing. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Nah, you won't hold because you're too fat. That's too bad. That would have been up one place. Will you hold here? You kind of hold here. The problem is I don't know what you're seeing. Oh, I can tilt you. Oh, beautiful. Okay. So, I assume you're seeing the RPM gauge. I'm assuming. Oh, I got it. My steering will hit it. Okay, that's not working. That's too bad. Okay, what can I do? Once again, I should have thought this through. I apologize. But hey, slice of life. Enjoy. The angle is probably crap. Oh, I switched that. You know what? I'm probably extremely wrong, but I think that's good. What I'm gonna do? I'm gonna lower my steering. Hopefully, you can see the RPM gauge better. You gotta understand, this is now supported by my belt, so when I breathe, it's gonna move. Sorry about that. Hope this gives you an idea. Anyway, okay, here we go. Check my blind spots. Applying the clutch right here. Handbrake down. You know what? I'm gonna move this, sorry. Because I wanna make sure it stays steady. So I'm gonna put it so it's going downward instead of going upwards. Is that any better? That'd be funny if it was better before, wouldn't it? There it is a bit, huh? Okay, let's hope that's legal. I wish this thing had a viewfinder now. I really do. Good thing I'm allowed videos longer than 15 minutes. Huh? Alright, here we go. Hopefully that's good. No, it's sagging. You're probably just seeing my steering wheel. I also don't want to make it too visible. I don't want to look like I'm up to shenanigans. Okay. Let's hope for the best. Here we go. Clutch press down. Handbrake disengaged. Gears in first. Let's see how much should we do. Gonna get on the highway now. Checking my blind spots. Keeping my eye on the road, most important. Hopefully you're looking at the RPM gauge. I'm now in fourth gear. Gonna get back on that highway. Going down to third gear. I'll explain the ratios in a minute. On the highway. Fourth gear. Coming up to a curve to get onto the highway. Apply a bit of Excel. Still in fourth gear. It's riding the clutch there. RPMs, 60 kilometers an hour. Fifth gear, 2000 RPMs. I'll leave it around this. 2005, 85 kilometers an hour. Stay in this lane. both hands on the steering. Only disengage one hand to use the gear shift or, you know, control such as turn signals or what have you. Gonna take this on ramp, this off ramp I should say, gonna do some boulevard throttle. I'm disengaging the gear completely. Let gravity take its force, applying a bit of brake. Car slowing down too much. Apply the clutch, put it in fifth gear. It was for nothing though, because I'm coming to a stop. I have the red light, that's fine. Car is now in neutral, foot's off the clutch, foot's on the brake. Exciting video, isn't it? Doing nothing. Foot's always on the brake, not on the clutch, no need, because my car is not in gear. If it was in gear, I'd have to have it on the clutch. While on brake, applying clutch, putting it in second, start with second. Due to synchronization, release the clutch slowly, apply the gas slowly. Second gear. Third gear. Sorry, I gotta get shaky at home. Still in third gear. Once again, every resume Excel is essentially clutch off, brake, gas on. But once again, in a steady and slow manner, never quick. If you do it quick, what'll happen? Your RPMs will shoot down, your car will stall, or your RPMs will shoot up because you're applying gas quick, and you'll cause an incredible amount of wear on your engine and transmission. Come to a stop, gear shifts to neutral. I can tell by tapping it in one or the other direction it has movement. I could release the clutch. Foot still on the brake, of course, we're at a stop. Isn't that fun? That's fun. Okay, here we go. RPMs, 52 kilometers.